meaning of computer, introduction of computer. What is it in my slide? Computer is an electronic machine which used it to accept data, to input, process, and store for the future retrievals. So we also, after knowing the definition, we say important issues in computer input, process, output, and storage, according to the definition. What we input data, and we get output of information in computers. Also, there's something which this is in my slide, but you didn't ask me. There's computer system. We discussed about hardware, software. Then users and data will come later. Computer can convert data into information. You input data, you get output as information. Also in my slide, we categorize computer according to those issues. Generation, we can call it, or we can call it categories of computers. We have microcomputer that we have now, laptop, notebook, notepad, palm top, and the other personal computer. We call it micro computers. And then we have mini computers. These are very small computers at the workstations. For example, at the point supermarket, we see, or point of terminal, see some small tablet to capture some data. That we call mini computer. Then we have mainframe computers used by large organizations, which have almost 1,000 terminals, often remote. For example, you can have a point here, and for example, a bank can have one branch here, another branch at another country. So they share the data remotely. So that we call it mainframe computers, type of that computer. Also, we have supercomputers. In Africa, we have almost 5 supercomputers. It is in Tanzania, in Cairo, South Africa, Nigeria, and other countries. Almost 5 computers, 5 countries which have supercomputers. So these are large computers used by large industries such as NASA for checking various of data, comparing, analyzing, and manipulating. For example, at NASA, they have NASA, you know NASA? Yeah. Well, stock exchange and the other site like that. So that is how you can see somebody. Now we are going to see someone, people, users, and then we have computers, he feed data, and then at the end of the day he gets an information. So data means raw fact. Information which has not well processed is what we call it data. Information means the meaningful information. Data which is well organized, it is called information. So actually the computer can input, we input data, then process, then storage, at the end output. But output what? Okay. Data means raw fact, information which has no meaning. Okay? Even the women, they tend to ask it, they are friend. Then we are going to the definition of computer. We have data, input, process, storage, output. Then we get information. Sometimes ICM asks this. Okay, also we discussed about two major areas of computer system, which is hardware and software. And we started to hardware. And I said hardware, this is the physical or mechanical part of the computer system. Tangible part of the computer system, it is called the hardware. Anything which you can touch in the computer, it is called the hardware. Anything which you can touch, all tangible parts of the computer, it is called the hardware. Software, it is not touchable unless it is in CD or flash or anywhere. But and we saw the examples of hardware, printer, device. Also, we saw
major category of hardware, input device, processor, storage device, output device. Input device, I said, is a device used for entering data into the computer, example, keyboard, microphone, mouse, scanner, microphone, digital camera. I used it for entering data into the computer. Or in means input, two ways, input, enter and data, output, display, for display. So, keyboards, microphone, mouse, scanner, digital camera. So today we are going to discuss in detail this. Also, we discussed the processor group, which is the processor or CPU, central processing unit. This is the brain of the computer, I say. It contains three units, control unit, arithmetic logic unit, and the memory unit. Okay, we discussed in detail. Control unit, I said, it control and monitor different activities within the computers. Then we discussed about all which perform calculation decision makings. Also, we discussed about memory. And I said there are two types of memory. Everybody has two types of memory. Permanent and which is temporary memory. Permanent, which RAM is temporary memory, it is called random access memory, and ROM, read-only memory. And the RAM, I said, used to store data temporary, read and write. It is primary memory, it is volatile, lose data in the event that any computer failure can lose the data once. But for ROM, it's opposite of RAM. And RAM you can find inside the machines. Once you open the machine, there is a RAM and so. But not for this lesson is not the issue. We are not going to discuss how to open the machine to see RAM and what CPU processor, but you have to believe there is memory, there is RAM, there is everything inside the computers. Okay? You need to appreciate there is. Okay? This is. Okay. And RAM is a volatile, meaning it holds data only when the power is on. When the power is off, RAM contents are lost. You see? It holds data when the power is on. Once you switch on the computer, RAM contents are lost. So we are going to ROM. ROM means read-only memory. It is usually to find permanent. It is not volatile. It is easy to store. That's all about the processor for your level. But there is a lot of questions ICM asked regarding this difference between RAM and ROM. So today, and then we discuss about storage device. These are devices used to store data, such as flash disk, memory, and hard disk, CDs, and a lot of devices we discussed about these topics. So, also we said there are those which located internally, we call it, such as hard disk. These are internal storage devices located internally. For example, in your mobile. Also, we discussed about the output device. We said these are devices used for displaying information or producing information in a soft copy or hard copy. Soft copy means hard copy. Hard copy output, for example, the paper is kept on it. Soft copy one, which, for example, you write it on your seat. You cannot touch the soft copy. Right? So, I asked the question, which one is better? Hard copy or soft copy? Okay? You say hard copy, some say hard copy, some say soft copy is better. But the answer is also CM asked that question. And that was the end of the hardware devices. So we go to software. And then we discuss the meaning, definition of the software, programs or instructions or apps. So we discussed two major areas of software, which were application software. These are programs designed for assisting users in their daily activities, such as Microsoft Office, MS Word, and the other programs. We call it application software. And the second group, we call it system software. So if you go to the market,
Let me explain it. Also, we discussed about the system software, or we can call it operating system. These are programs which manage the hardware and the other application programs. We said there are two. We have hardware and the software. So, operating system manage the hardware and the other application program. Manage hardware and the other operating program. I told you, system software, these are programs that manage the operation of a computer. It means it manage hardware and the other application what programs. But application software, these are programs that help user to perform the task. Okay? So, last but not least, we have discussed about the features of modern PC. Any modern PC should have at least all those features. Eh? At least 10 or 5 of them. 10 of them should have speed, memory, operating system, hard disk, display, video card, webcam, CD, network cards, wireless card, USB sticks, external portable device, and locks. We discussed a lot, some of them. So you can go and just read it for yourself. And last is review questions. I hope you have done the review questions.